When we talk about ocean literacy, we are talking about understanding the ocean's influence on you and your influence on the ocean. So if we're talking about an interconnectedness between ourselves and the ocean, we are in some way talking about ocean literacy. When I'm asked, why should we be doing this now? Why the urgency? Why should we make this a priority in teaching and learning? I can't help but go past the United Nations view of this as a global community, saying this is basically the last decade in which we get to take meaningful actions for meaningful outcomes to secure our futures. Probably familiar with this sort of iconography here. I've used this a lot, taught with the UN Sustainability Goals. I love Goal 14, Life Below Water, because it focuses on the oceans and our connections with the oceans. That single image, though, we can also then further articulate in terms of these seven ocean literacy principles. What I love about this, where my connection came, was I was like, yeah, like, I get it. I want to support people to support the oceans, protect the oceans, but what are we actually talking about? So when it came, when I sort of found out about the ocean literacy principles and found that there were these seven key, like, core points that we could focus on, as an educator, it made me go, right, I can actually sort of use these quite specifically to help my students to learn. I think one of the main reasons that Australia needs to take this opportunity and this need really seriously is that as the largest island, populated island on Earth, we are all surrounded by coastline. The activities that we undertake on land affect what happens in the oceans. What happens in the oceans inevitably affects our quality of life. There are ample opportunities for any school, any geography, regardless of their proximity to coast, to actually be a part of an ocean literacy, you know, understanding and program. Because when we think about it, all of the catchments, wherever you live, whatever catchment you're in, they all end up in the ocean. So we sent out a survey recently to really find out from teachers where are they currently at in understanding ocean literacy, how important do they think ocean literacy is in terms of the teaching and learning. The results of the survey were really quite profound, and what we discovered was that there's a very high, what we would call, intention to teach. What we also found is there's not a lot of confidence. So with that kind of misalignment between, yes, I want to teach, I want my students to learn about ocean literacy, but I'm like, oh, where do I start? What's it all about? How do I kind of implement this into my teaching and learning program? How do I link this in with curriculum? Most important thing that teachers said, if I can just hit the ground running with it, without having to do a lot of preparation, I would love to teach in this space. In many schools, possibly even most, when we get to those parts, we're actually teaching about what we would now think of as ocean literacy. Just about all of the resources and the focus tends to be on the Great Barrier Reef. Understandably, it's a, you know, such an amazing, you know, natural phenomenon. What we often overlook is that we actually have at least an equally unique and important ecosystem right on our doorstep, which is the Great Southern Reef. So what we're looking to do now is to say, we love the Great Barrier Reef. We also need to connect, respect, and protect our own Great Southern Reef. I think it's really important, particularly when we're talking with our young people about the importance of things like ocean literacy and the Great Southern Reef, that it's not all about the bad news. I think they're kind of like, they know there are issues and problems. One of the things that I like to talk to students about is probtunities. So you see the problem, but with the right kind of thinking and working together, we can often turn a problem not just into a solution, not just to kind of cease that to be a problem, but actually leverage an opportunity. The real value of ocean literacy is not just in the content and learning knowledge, it's actually about that context and connection with the marine environment. So our young people today, when they're able to actually have that deeper connection and experience with our unique marine environment, they're more able to take that, to see those opportunities, to take the opportunities and ideally create opportunities for themselves and others that both support the Great Southern Reef and also support their own goals and aspirations. We have a responsibility to make sure that our young people are as fully empowered and informed as they can possibly be to shape the futures that they want and need. In a following video, we'll talk about how you can easily then implement ocean literacy principles in your classroom and help your students to not only undertake deep and authentic learning, but really to take action.